Hi, my name is Barbara Brown. I'm the school outreach coordinator for the ALS Ride for Life. You know, I know how sad all of you were when you heard about the passing of Chris Pendergast, as were we. However, we all have to be so thankful that we played a small part in Chris's fight against ALS. You know, Chris battled ALS for 28 years. Isn't that amazing? And during that time, he was able to give hope to countless ALS patients and their families, all while inspiring each and every one of us to never, ever give up in the face of adversity. You know, the one way we can honor Chris's legacy is by continuing his mission in the fight against ALS. And that just doesn't mean trying to find the cure. It means helping all those poor ALS patients that are right here in our own communities. You know, one special person to the Ride for Life family is Paul Weissman. Paul's been battling ALS for a number of years. He's visited many of your schools. And right now I want to introduce Paul, who's going to give you a little bit of info about how ALS affects his life. And he's also going to ask you to please continue your support against this deadly disease. Thank you.
I was told I have ALS back in January of 2013. The disease is moving slowly for me, but it is moving. I joined with the ALS Ride for Life and did my first ride back in 2015. And I've been on the road ever since trying to raise as much awareness and as much money as I can to try to find a cure for ALS. ALS has taken away the use of my hands, my arms, and my legs are definitely getting weaker. I need help with just about everything. Somebody has to feed me, shower me, dress me. So the older I get, I'm kind of turning back into an infant. Granted, an infant with a beard, but still an infant. Now, I might have ALS, but ALS does not have me. Now, y'all might be going through some tough stuff right now, but hopefully by next school year, COVID-19 will be gone. But unfortunately, ALS will still be here, and I need your help. Every 90 minutes, somebody is diagnosed with ALS. And unfortunately, every 90 minutes, someone also dies from ALS. I'm looking forward to next school year when we can get together and meet in person. By the time next school year comes around, there's a very, very strong chance that I will be in a wheelchair. But I promise, with your help, I will never stop fighting. Together, we can get through all this. So never give up, never lose hope, always remain optimistic, and be willing to defy the odds. So until we meet again, peace, love, cure ALS. Thank you.
If you hear this message, wherever you stand, I'm calling every woman, calling every man. We're the generation, we can't afford to wait. The future started yesterday, and we're already late. We've been looking for a song to sing. We search for a melody, search for someone to lead. Looking for the world to change. If you feel the same, then go on and say, if you're out there, sing along with me. If you're out there, I'm dying to believe that you're out there. Stand up and say it loud. We'll be right back. promises, no more call to war. Less is love and peace that we're really fighting for. We can destroy hunger, we can conquer hate. Put down the arms and raise your voice. We're joining hands today. For a leader, but the leader was me.
We were looking for the world to change.
We can be heroes, just go on and say, if you're out there, sing along with me. If you're out there, I'm dying to believe that you're out there. Stand up and say it loud. Message, wherever you stand, I'm calling every woman, calling every man. We're the generation we can't afford to wait. The future started yesterday, and we're already late.
Thank you, Barbara and Paul. What fond memories that video of previous rides brings to mind. My name is Ray Manzoni, and I am president and chairman of the ALS Ride for Life. I wanted to introduce myself and thank all of you for the support you have provided, and we hope will continue as we move forward in these very challenging COVID times. I know you share in our sorrow with the passing of our founder, Christopher Pendergast. But Chris would be the first to say that ALS Ride for Life is not about one person. It's about helping ALS patients like Paul and about finding an ALS cure. We want you to know that the ALS Ride for Life journey will continue towards that cure and in Chris's name. Now, please help me welcome a key person helping us continue Chris's fight, our Executive Director, Marilyn Sloan.
Thank you, Ray. Did you know that one of Chris's favorite ride activities was visiting over 90 schools throughout Long Island and New York City? Did you know that the ride's biggest source of fundraising comes from schools just like yours, raising almost $100,000 each year? We miss presenting our school program to you, so we needed to get creative and visit you virtually. We have made a lot of changes over the past year. We now have the necessary software to offer you the ability to fundraise virtually. Schools can still have fun while supporting the ride by hosting fundraisers like Pajama Day, Readathons, even a virtual walk or raffle. There are many fundraising opportunities. If your school is interested in fundraising, you can reach out to Barbara Brown, our school coordinator. And if you want information on how our new software can make the process easier, please reach out to me. We appreciate your support and we look forward to working with you, not only to find a cure for ALS, but to offer patient services to people like Paul to help make their day easier.